trying to start the vehicle. There isn't even any light on the dashboard. Either the battery is completely drained, or there is a problem in the electrical connections. Checking the battery first. Multimeter on 20 volts DC. volts, a fully charged vehicle battery should not read below 12.6 volts. Even if it's a good battery, draining it to this low voltage will damage it. I will try to recharge the battery, and then perform a parasitic draw test. This battery was working normally before, without any weak symptoms, so I suspect there's a parasitic drain. In this time, I will check the alternator diode first to see if it's draining the battery. To check the alternator diode, the battery should be disconnected. The alternator diode should pass current only one way, from the alternator to the battery, but not also the opposite way. Multimeter on diode mode. Connecting the multimeter leads one to the B plus post on the alternator, and the other on the alternator case, and then swap the leads. One way you should get a reading from 0.2 to 1.3 volts for most vehicles, and the other way you should get a very high resistance or OL. I fully charged the battery to 12.6 volts. Connecting the positive terminal first. I then disconnected the negative terminal and left it overnight to make sure the battery is good. Trying to start the vehicle the next day. The battery worked fine, so there is something draining the battery when it's connected. Now performing a battery parasitic draw test, making sure that all electrical components of the vehicle are turned off, such as lights, radio, heater or AC. Also unplug all devices from the vehicle, and make sure to close the glove box, and all the doors. In some vehicles, you may need to reset the anti-theft system or input a code to turn on the vehicle after disconnecting the battery. Setting the multimeter to the highest amperes, here is 15 amperes. Disconnecting the negative terminal, and connecting the multimeter in series, between the negative terminal and the negative battery cable. Now leave the multimeter connected for several minutes, for the vehicle electrical system to sleep, and the multimeter to set to a fixed number. Some vehicles can take up to 30 minutes to enter sleep mode. For newer models, with a lot of electronic systems, a normal drainage number should not exceed 0.1 amperes, with only a few exceptions. Here after a while, it sets on 0.14 amperes. To identify the source of the parasitic drain, start by removing the fuses one by one, until the current draw drops significantly, to know which circuit is likely the source of drain. Removing some fuses may cause the multimeter reading to drop slightly, which is normal. Some electrical components constantly draw power, such as the security system and the clock. What are you looking for is a significant drop. When you find the circuit that's creating the drain, return the fuse to its place, and check the owner's manual to find out the components that are powered by this circuit. Then start disconnecting each component one at a time, till the multimeter reading drops significantly, to identify the faulty component that's creating the drain. Also check for any damaged wiring that might also draw excessive power. If you checked all the fuses in the engine compartment and didn't find the source of draw, then check the fuses that's located under the steering wheel or in the glove box. After checking all the fuses in the engine compartment, I didn't find the source of draw. Before opening the door and checking the interior fuses, it's better to disconnect the multimeter. If the light switch is on, they might exceed the multimeter maximum draw amperes and damage it. You should disable the door switch before continuing, for the electrical system to enter sleep mode and the dashboard and interior lights to switch off. You might also have this type of door switch, you should also disable it. Now checking the interior fuses. I couldn't film easily here, but this is the fuse that's creating the significant draw.